Nevada's morning news source. You're watching Fox 4 Rising.
Good morning, Southwest Florida. You're taking a live look at the radar. As you can see, rain is not a factor right now, but later today, some showers could pop up. I'm Stephanie Tinoco. We want to send it right over to Tony Sidigu. Tony, I heard conditions are just right for fog and rain may be a problem. What's our forecast look like this morning?
Hey, good morning, Stephanie. We are tracking some unsettled weather building into the afternoon, so maybe a good idea to grab the umbrella as you head out the door. As you can see right now, no problem with radar, no problem with rain, but take a look at the forecast. As we make our way through the commute hour, we're all good. The lunch hour, it's a mostly sunny day. I think it's going to be a really nice day overall, but as we make our way to 2, 3 o'clock, you know the time. Kids may be heading home from school. You may be heading home from work. We could begin to see some pop-up showers and then some heavier rains as we make our way through the early evening hours, mainly along maybe just to the east of I-75. These will be pushing towards the coast. So it could mean for some active weather building into late in the day. I'll have more on your extended forecast, of course, coming up in 3 minutes. Stephanie.
Thanks, Tony. We're following breaking news out of St. Petersburg. A SWAT situation just ended about 2 hours ago. This is the video just into our newsroom for our sister station in Tampa. We're told a man barricaded himself inside a home with a child inside. That child was not injured. The man did surrender peacefully around 3 this morning, and police say the man argued with his wife and fired a shot before running to a neighbor's house. That neighbor got out of the house, leaving the man and his 6-year-old child inside. He's now facing several charges, including domestic aggravated assault. And brand new, as you wake up, an Australia teen is set to appear in court today after being arrested in connection to a terror plot targeting an Australian Veterans Day service. It's the second year in a row authorities have stopped an attack linked to the national holiday. The 16-year-old is charged with a terrorism offense after being arrested at his home yesterday. He has been denied bail and is expected to appear in children's court later today. Police believe the boy was planning to attack an Anzac Day ceremony in Sydney this morning.
Unfortunately, this is part of a pattern that we have been observing where people are targeted, younger and younger people are targeted and incited to go and commit an act of terror. We're very concerned about this, and that's why we've been working very closely with the Muslim community in particular on strategies to counter violent extremism.
Last year, a 15-year-old British boy was sentenced to life for plotting against police at an Anzac Day parade in Australia. The 16-year-old faces life in prison if convicted. Now today, President Obama is set to announce that an additional 250 military personnel will head to Syria to help local forces fighting the Islamic State group. This increases the number of troops to 300 U.S. forces battling extremists in the war-torn country. Right now, there are about 50 already there, and the president is set to make the announcement today in Germany at the close of a week-long trip where ISIS was a focus of his meetings with the world leaders in Saudi Arabia, Great Britain, and Germany. And the Obama administration could release secret documents about the September 11th attacks any moment. The document could shed light on the possible Saudi connections to the attacks. The disclosure would come at a time of strained U.S. relations with Saudi Arabia, a longtime American ally. An investigation is underway after a deadly shooting at a Pennsylvania church. Police say a fight broke between two church members, resulting in one person shooting and killing the other. The shooting happened yesterday morning at the Keystone Fellowship Church in Montgomery County, Pennsylvania. Police arrived to find 27-year-old Robert Braxton with a gunshot wound to the chest. Braxton was pronounced dead shortly after at a local hospital. The other person involved is cooperating with police and hasn't been charged so far. Authorities are scrambling to determine who killed 8 family members in a pre-planned execution that has shaken residents of their rural southern Ohio community. 7 adults and 1 teenage boy were found shot in the head on Friday. 3 young children were not harmed, and authorities have refused to discuss many details of the crime, a potential motive, weapons, or the search for the assailant or assailants. They say they found marijuana operations at 3 of the crime scenes, but didn't say if the deaths were linked to pot. And brand new this morning, embattled quarterback Johnny Manziel has been indicted by a Dallas County grand jury on a misdemeanor assault charge. The formal announcement is expected today. Manziel's case was heard by a grand jury on Thursday. The former Cleveland Browns quarterback and Heisman Trophy winner at Texas A&M is accused of hitting his ex-girlfriend so hard she temporarily lost hearing in one ear.
It's 5:05 as you wake up with us on this Monday morning. I think if you grab the umbrella any day this week, today would be a good day to do it. We've got some active weather. It's brewing mainly out to the west in the Gulf of Mexico, an upper-level disturbance that's going to track just east and over the state here over the afternoon, helping to increase rain chances, and that is what we're watching for today. In the meantime, Doppler radar, no worries for the morning commute, but I think the evening commute and into the evening hours, we could see some rain develop. There's 3 o'clock. You can see some spotty rains developing on both sides of I-75. So I don't think it's going to be only an inland rain event. I think areas like Port Charlotte, 4 miles down to Naples, could see quite a bit of rain from this as well. As we get a sea breeze develop, that could focus the heavier of the rains or just to the east of I-75. But note, as the rains do develop, they will push on back towards the coast. So that could mean wet weather lingering just till late here, close to the midnight hour for today. So definitely wanted to give you the heads up on that. Otherwise, we do have conditions favorable for fog. We've yet to see any, though, at this time. Visibility is still looking good for that morning commute. Temperatures, though, you step out the door, nothing cool about these numbers. Average is typically mid-60s, and we're seeing more 70s on the board. Some 67s out there in Palmdale, as well as LaBelle and Immokalee, 66 now, but solid on 70 in Fort Myers, 71 in Cape Coral this morning. So no need for the jacket as you head out the door. Your day planner for today calls for temperatures to be very toasty into the afternoon. We'll see plenty of sunshine. So overall, a really nice day, very similar to what we enjoyed over the weekend with easterly winds building in out of the south. That will help to crank up the humidity just a tad. Your high temperature for today, about 86 under mostly sunny skies. Once again, some scattered rain developing. Coverage only about a 40%, so not everybody's going to see it, and it's certainly not going to ruin your day. Of course, we'll have more on that part of the forecast and your extended forecast coming up in about 10 minutes. Good morning, Stephanie.
Now, on-time traffic brought to you by Associates and Bruce L. Shiner, attorneys for the injured.
Good morning, Southwest Florida. Happy Monday. Here's a good look at your morning commute on this Monday morning. Everything in Fort Myers this morning looking good. No delays, no traffic accidents to report at this time. If you're heading down Colonial, I know a lot of you are taking that this morning. Just about 6 minutes. We'll have some construction there, having some causing some lane closures that we'll talk about in just a little bit. But your commute down Daniels also looking good and green. And if you're traveling across your midpoint Cape Coral Bridge this morning, things are looking good. Your midpoint over to 41, that's just about 5 minutes. If you're traveling across the Cape Coral Bridge right now, about 7 minutes, and both 75 and 41 looking good at this time. We'll send it back to the desk.
Thanks, Steph. A Southwest Florida man is living under a cloud of community suspicion after his dad's body was found dismembered, and he could walk out of Lee County Jail at any moment. 33-year-old Matthew Marshall only faces a charge for misdemeanor fraud. He's accused of using his dad's credit card at a Cape Coral bar right after he went missing. The remains of his father, Rick, were eventually found in the woods and a nearby canal near his Cape Coral condo. Jail staff tell us a judge ordered Matthew to wear a GPS device in order to bond him out. He has to pay for that device before he can walk out a free man, at least temporarily. While Matthew is not charged with the murder, this is what some of his neighbors had to say about the possibility of him being released.
I called my sister-in-law, who's not from the area, and I was freaking out.
I hope that he didn't kill him, and I really hope that he doesn't come back here if he did.
Investigators also looked at credit card history to help determine where Matthew was the night his father disappeared. Records show Matthew used his father's credit card to buy beer at a local Walmart before using it again to ride to Backstreet's Bar in Cape Coral, and then made multiple calls and cancellations for an Uber ride, with the last call made around midnight. That's when the card was blocked for suspicious activity. And the Florida Department of Law Enforcement now says a mysterious death in Hendry County is a murder. This is an update to a story we told you about last week. Deputies and state agents are investigating the body that was found Thursday in this desolate area you see here on the screen off Wheeler Road and 14th Place. Although authorities haven't confirmed who the victim is, Family members of this woman here, 50-year-old Alberta Harris, believe the body is hers. She was last seen on April 11th, and 2 days later, her car was found along Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard, bloodied with a broken window. And you would think that as primary season enters the home stretch, no serious candidate would effectively agree to lose in any state. But that is basically what Ted Cruz and John Kasich said they would do if three contests scheduled for May and June. The announcement came late last night after a major conservative donor told Sunday talk show that Hillary Clinton might be better than any of the Republicans. Kim Hutcherson has more.
John Kasich and Ted Cruz announce a plan to deny Donald Trump the Republican presidential nomination. In a statement released late Sunday, Kasich's campaign said it would stand down in Indiana in order to, quote, give the Cruz campaign a clear path in the state. In its own statement, the Cruz campaign said it would return the favor in Oregon and New Mexico. Trump laughed off the strategy, calling it, quote, desperation. The plan is the latest indication of mainstream Republican concern over a Trump candidacy. Donor Charles Koch shares those concerns, blasting Trump's stance on Muslims on ABC This Week.
We'll have them all register. That's reminiscent of Nazi Germany. I mean, that's monstrous, as I said at the time.
But Ted Cruz's threat to carpet bomb ISIS came up for criticism as well.
That a candidate, whether they believe it or not, would think that appeals to the American people. This is frightening.
Then Koch made this surprising statement.
Is it possible another Clinton could be better than another Republican?
It's possible. It's possible.
It seems this strange political season is getting even stranger. Kim Hutcherson, Fox 4 in your corner.
The agreement devised by Kasich and Cruz covers primaries scheduled for May and June. Their plan doesn't involve the so-called ACE primaries coming up tomorrow. And we're getting new information about the death of Florida zookeeper. We'll explain the policy the zookeeper wasn't following moments before a tiger attacked her. Plus, a lost boat has been found. It's the boat that two Florida teens were on when they vanished last summer. Now the families hope some personal items found on the boat will help determine what happened to the teens. Also, rain may be on the way here in Southwest Florida. Today's the greatest chance of rain for the week. We're checking it in with Tony next to see if you'll need your umbrellas.
Get it now at fox4now.com.
Who has time to make freshly brewed coffee every morning? Who has time to crack eggs? Who has time to brown a slice of Canadian bacon to perfection? We do. That's why you don't have to worry. We got you. See you tomorrow at the drive-thru.
And during this event, you can get a great deal on this Jetta.
It drives great.
Volkswagen believes safety is very important, so all 11 models come standard with an intelligent crash response system. And 7 stability-enhancing systems. For more confidence on road trips.
For those who take safety seriously, like we do, the Volkswagen Safety in Numbers event is happening now. Lease a 2016 Jetta S for $129 a month after a $1,000 bonus.
Look, I know you're a cow and all, and you may not know what I'm talking about, but the yogurt made from your milk is delicious.
Yoplait.
Arm & Hammer brings a sensational spin on the new Spin Brush Truly Radiant Clean and Fresh. The patented dual-action head with floss-tip bristles removes 100% more plaque in hardest-to-reach places. I feel truly radiant. New Spin Brush Truly Radiant.
Nivea In-Shower Body Lotion. First I wash, next I apply it to my wet skin and rinse. I get 24-hour moisture with no sticky feel. Then I'm ready to go. Nivea In-Shower Body Lotion in the body lotion aisle.
Tender steak, crispy onions, and steak butter with garlic and chives for $1.99? That's high fashion flavor at a thrift store price. The buttery steak burger, Checkers and Rallies, fast foodies know the deal.
The E-Class has 11 intelligent driver assist systems. It recognizes pedestrians and alerts you. Warns you about incoming cross traffic. Cameras and radar detect dangers you don't. and it can even stop by itself. So in this crash test, one thing's missing. A crash. The 2016 E-Class. Lease the E350 for $499 a month at your local Mercedes-Benz dealer. Mercedes-Benz, the best or nothing.
Happy Monday. It's 5:15. Wanted to show you the big picture of the synoptic map here across satellite radar, rather, across the country. You can see what's happening now. There's an area of low pressure developing out there close to Iowa and Minnesota. Going to bring lots of rain and active weather for them as we take a look at severe weather potential. Many folks in a slight risk anywhere from Wisconsin down to Chicago and central Illinois. That's going to be the picture for today. But watch how things rapidly change. Here coming up here for Tuesday, where some folks will be seeing some strong thunderstorms as well as some strong tornadoes with very potent area low pressure that'll develop back out towards the Rockies and then swing into the Midwest. So areas like Nebraska, Kansas, and Oklahoma will be in a moderate risk for seeing severe weather, and that is certainly going to be some big news here over the coming days. Just for some perspective, when we got tornadoes here in the Cape in January, we were only in a slight risk. So some very active weather brewing out just to the north and to the west of us. In the meantime, we are staying dry here for this morning. We do have the chance for some scattered showers to develop as we make our way into the afternoon. Note 3 o'clock, mainly along and just to the east of I-75, seeing some scattered rains. The activity, I think, could intensify closer to the drive home, the early evening hours, where we do get a sea breeze develop, and that could certainly enhance the convergence that we see. This model, I think, overdoing it just a tad, but you get the picture. Some rain is certainly possible, not a washout scenario, but certainly late afternoon, early evening hours, bank on the rains, certainly could be making their way towards your backyard. Of course, we haven't seen much rain lately, so any rain we could get will be a good thing for today. Temperatures this morning, 60s and 70s. Those dew points are not where we like to see them. They are in the 60s. So that is going to translate to some mugginess out there for today. High temperatures, expect them into the mid to upper 80s this afternoon. Believe it or not, yesterday we just about tapped 90 degrees. At Page Field in Fort Myers. Could see more 90-degree days ahead here in the coming days. 7-day forecast for today. Some scattered rain in the afternoon. Temperatures not going anywhere. No cool down in the forecast. We'll see temperatures just about flirting with 90 degrees as we make our way towards next weekend. That is a look at your forecast. It is 5:17. Stephanie's got a look at traffic.
Now, on-time traffic brought to you by Associates and Bruce L. Shiner, attorneys for the injured.
Good Monday morning, everyone. Taking a look at Naples right now. Your commute this morning looking good as you head down Livingston Road. That's running about 40 miles per hour. Sander Bay Drive, that also running about 40 miles per hour, as well as if you are heading down Airport Pulling Road. No accidents or delays to report in this area of Naples this morning. Your commute also looks good down Davis Boulevard, about 7 minutes. We're seeing a little bit of slowdown right there at Collier Boulevard. Collier Boulevard to Kingsway, that is about 7 minutes. We're also going to have some construction going on Collier Boulevard throughout the morning between Golden Gate and Green Boulevard. But San Carlos Park through Estero and Bonita Springs, your commute looking good and green. Bonita Beach Road west to Alico Road, about 12 minutes. That is a look at your traffic.
Thanks, Stephanie. An agonizing discovery off Bermuda, a capsized boat. It's the last place two Florida teen boys were seen alive 8 months ago. Jimmy Johnson has more.
The search for the boat carrying 14-year-olds Austin Stefanos and Perry Cohen is now over. WPBF 25 News first told you about the teen's disappearance after sailing off the Jupiter Inlet last July on a fishing trip. An exhaustive search would follow, garnering national attention, but never any signs of Austin or Perry again. 8 months later, officials notified the teen's parents that the boat was found. The Cohen family telling us a crew aboard a Norwegian ship made the discovery about 100 miles off the coast of Bermuda in March. The boat capsized, but some personal items aboard were salvaged, including an iPhone the Cohen family believes belongs to Austin. Pamela Cohen, the mother of Perry, released this statement. It reads in part, "We urge Austin's family to do the right thing and to allow law enforcement to retain the iPhone until arrangements can be made to retain the top forensic teams available to begin to look for answers we so desperately need." The boat is now on its way back to South Florida and should arrive sometime in mid-May.
A marine supply sticker store and engine serial number helped authorities positively identify the boat. We're learning a Florida zookeeper who died in a tiger attack was not following the zoo's policy at the time of the attack. Stacy Conweiser was killed 2 weeks ago when a tiger attacked her at the Palm Beach Zoo. The zoo's president now says Conweiser entered a restricted area. Employees are not allowed to enter tiger enclosures where the tigers have access. Officials are still trying to determine why and how this happened. Right now, there are several investigations underway. An investigation is underway to see what brought down a small plane in South Carolina that killed one person. The incident happening yesterday in the Greenville County town of Belton. Witnesses say they saw the plane spiral down into a field before catching fire. Authorities say the pilot was trapped inside the plane after it crashed. He was the only person on board. And do you ever buy something only to find the same item goes on sale at a different store? Well, now there's a brand new app that can put that money back in your pocket. Plus, this allergy season has been rough, and if you're still holding out on seeing a doctor, a new campaign is working to change your mind. We're breaking down the easy process that can help you breathe easier. You're watching Fox 4 Rising.
See you tomorrow at the drive-thru.
Get ready for sun protection that stays on right through your game. Neutrogena Cool Dry Sport, the only sports sunscreen with clinically proven Helioplex. Play on with protection that stays on. Cool Dry Sport, Neutrogena.
If you've been injured in an automobile accident and have legal questions, visit ForThePeople.com to get answers to your questions. Morgan & Morgan, For the People.
Weekdays.
Why are you lying about something so stupid?
The courtroom gets three times tougher.
He's the worst dad in the world.
You're both embarrassed and humiliated now.
I've not heard a defense as ludicrous as the one that we just heard out there.
Three judges.
We don't like either side here.
Three opinions.
Are we ready to vote on this one?
One verdict. Hot Bench. Created by Judge Judy.
Let me explain.
I'm done.
Weekdays at 4 on Fox 4.
Yeah, more so than the front.
Taking care of your car isn't the first thing on your mind.
I'm ready!
Until it needs to be. At Tires Plus, we get it. That's why since 1976, we've offered the best selection of name brand tires, brakes, batteries, and oil, installed quickly by our qualified specialists. So you can get back to what you truly care about. Tires Plus. Get there from here.
Nissan's family of crossovers with intuitive all-wheel drive. See driving in a more confident light. For a limited time, lease Rogue, just $189 per month, or save up to $1,250. Take on Mother Nature. Shop ChooseNissan.com.
The Rooms To Go store-wide mattress sale ends Monday. So hurry in and save big on this luxurious special purchase Therapeutic Pillow Top Queen mattress set for just $299. $299. Plus get big savings on other amazing mattress sets from the best brands. Like this Sealy Posturepedic Queen set, just $577. This Beautyrest Recharge Queen set, $577. Or this Serta Perfect Sleeper Queen set, also just $577. Remember, the Rooms To Go store-wide mattress sale ends Monday.
Itchy noses and watery eyes are a popular trend here in Southwest Florida this allergy season. But a new educational campaign aims to raise awareness at the seriousness of nasal allergies. It encourages allergy sufferers to be proactive in treating their symptoms each season. Actress Allison Hannigan is teaming up with the Asthma and Allergy Foundation of America to make it clear that allergies are no laughing matter.
The test takes 20 minutes. You find out right then and there, and it's so easy. Now they don't even have to do it with needles, which a lot of people are afraid of.
Right. Yeah.
And so it's so much easier than it was back in my day.
Experts say allergists can test what triggers your allergies and prescribe the right treatment to help you breathe easier.
Treatment many Southwest Floridians are gonna need because the allergies are not letting up anytime soon. They've certainly come down since the last couple weeks, but maybe you've been suffering with them like I have. the oak, the bayberry, the grass, all of those the major culprits as we take a look at the forecast. Your allergy report shows we are staying socked into the medium risk here all the way through much of the week. So that is just a quick look at that. Certainly going to need the Kleenex on hand as well as the umbrellas for today. We've got some rain in the forecast as well. Right now, checking in at 68 in Punta Gorda, partly cloudy skies, easterly winds at about 7. So feeling pretty mild and muggy for a start here today. 70 degrees in Fort Myers, waking up to clear skies, and it's 71 right now. Dew points about 64. We've been talking about these dew points. Last week we had really comfortable dew points early in the week in the Pleasant range, but we have seen that number really starting to shift, and right now we're kind of in between sticky and uncomfortable, but by the end of the work week, we are going to be locked into that uncomfortable range. Our dew points really not going to go anywhere. We're not really going to get any cold fronts that will change our air mass, and as a result of that, we are going to be dealing with not only the warm temperatures, but the humidity that comes along with it as well. So very summer-like feel, very summer-like soup. That's what's in store for you Monday, much of the work week as well. For today, we go to 86. By the 2 o'clock hour, temperatures hanging in the 80s much of the afternoon. We will see some scattered showers build in mainly late afternoon, maybe evening commute, early evening hours. High temperature, check them out, 88. So some folks, I mentioned it earlier, yesterday we got to 90 degrees in Fort Myers. Would not be surprised if we came close. Records are safe, though. We'll go to 86 in Naples, 86 in Marco Island. We'll have another look at your forecast in 10 minutes right now. Stephanie's checking your roads for you.
Now, on-time traffic brought to you by Associates and Bruce L. Shiner, attorneys for the injured.
Okay, take a look at this. If you are traveling across the midpoint or the Cape Coral Bridge this morning, your commute is looking clear. Just about 5 minutes over the water across your midpoint bridge. Your Cape Coral Bridge still looking at about 7 minutes, so nothing to worry about there. Now, if you are heading into Fort Myers, I want you to look at Colonial here because you're going to see some lane closures going east and westbound due to that long-term construction that we've been talking about during the early morning hours. So that's going to kind of alternate lanes throughout the morning. It's going to be right there at 75. Down Colonial right now, you see a little bit of slowdown at 41, but again, that construction is going to be Colonial and 75. That's a look at your traffic. We'll send it back to the desk.
It's a surfer's nightmare.
It really hurt, and I thought like it bit my whole foot off.
A Florida teen comes face to face with a shark while catching a wave. We're hearing from him for the first time coming up. Plus, the son of a murdered Cape Coral realtor may be getting out of jail soon. He's facing charges for using his dad's credit card the day after his dad disappeared. We'll have an update on the case next. Plus, it may be a rainy start to the week. We'll let you know when you may be dodging showers. You're watching Fox 4 Rising.
Why chase trends when you can make a statement? The unmistakable Audi Q5. Experience the distinct Audi Q5 at your local dealer today.
Thank you so much.
Did you say honey?
Try some?
Mmm, that is tasty.
Thanks.
Is it real?
Of course. Are you?
Nope. Animated. You know, I'm always looking for real honey for Honey Nut Cheerios.
Well, you've come to the right place.
Great. Mind if I have another taste?
Not at all. You all right, bud?
Never better.
Oh, I don't know if he likes that. Yeah.
Part of the complete breakfast.
Enough's enough. We have too much. It's time to trade in and trade up. All new Kias at Galliano Kia must go. Let's trade keys. Come check out the all new 2017 Kia Sportage. We could even match your payment. Plus, get $1,000 more for your trade. And if you have a job bringing home $350 or more per week, we want to approve your credit. Visit Galliano Kia in Fort Myers, the trade leader, and see who really sells new Kias for less. GallianoKia.com.
Gotta go. Gotta go.
You're welcome.
Made with chicken fried fresh in-store throughout the day. Order a Publix Deli Chicken Tender Sub online anytime. Publix, where shopping is a pleasure.
For the last 5 days, 17 hours, and 23 minutes, you've been a passenger.
I'm back in baby's arms. How I miss those.
The Mazda 6 with SkyActive technology makes it good to be a driver.
Natural foods, a lifestyle of healthy living, now with 6 locations.
Welcome back. We're waking up to dry conditions on this Monday morning, but later today that may not be the case. We want to send it right over to Tony Sidiku. Tony, where are we going to see the most rain today?
Hey, good morning, Stephanie. We're going to be seeing rain, I think, all across Southwest Florida. That locations away from the coast, locations close to the coast, both going to get a good, a decent chance for seeing rain across the air. So I think wherever you live, good bet to grab the umbrellas this morning. No rain at the current time, just around 5:30. But as we take a look at the model data, you can start to see what happens. Some isolated showers developing by 2, 3 o'clock. The kids, I think, are going to need the umbrella if they live in Charlotte County, Lee County, and Collier. And so the story goes, you will as well if you're going to be around late this evening. We'll have more on your full forecast coming up in 3 minutes. Steph?
Thanks, Tony. We're following breaking news out of St. Petersburg. A SWAT situation just ended about 2 hours ago. This is the video just into our newsroom for our sister station in Tampa. We're told a man barricaded himself inside a home with a child inside. The child wasn't injured. The man did surrender peacefully around 3 a.m. this morning. Police say the man argued with his wife and fired a shot before running to a neighbor's house, and that neighbor got out of the house, leaving the man and his 6-year-old child inside. He's now facing several charges, including domestic aggravated assault. And brand new as you wake up, an Australia teen is set to appear in court today after being arrested in connection to a terror plot targeting an Australian Veterans Day service. It's the second year in a row authorities have stopped an attack linked to the national holiday. The 16-year-old is charged with a terrorism offense after being arrested at his home yesterday. He has been denied bail and is expected to appear in children's court later today. Police believe the boy was planning to attack an Anzac Day ceremony in Sydney this morning.
Unfortunately, this is part of a pattern that we have been observing where people are targeted, younger and younger people are targeted and incited to go and commit an act of terror. We're very concerned about this, and that's why we've been working very closely with the Muslim community in particular on strategies to counter violent extremism.
Last year, a 15-year-old British boy was sentenced to life for plotting against police at an Anzac Day parade in Australia. This 16-year-old faces life in prison if convicted. A Southwest Florida man is living under a cloud of community suspicion after his dad's body was found dismembered, and he could walk out of Lee County Jail at any moment. 33-year-old Matthew Marshall only faces a charge for misdemeanor fraud. He's accused of using his dad's credit card at a Cape Coral bar right after he went missing. The remains of his father, Rick, were eventually found in the woods and a nearby canal near his Cape Coral condo. Now, jail staff tell us a judge ordered Matthew to wear a GPS device in order to bond out. He has to pay for that device before he can walk out a free man, at least temporarily. While Matthew is not charged with his father's murder, this is what some of his neighbors had to say about the possibility of him being released.
I called my sister-in-law, who's not from the area, and I was freaking out.
I hope that he didn't kill him, and I really hope that he doesn't come back here if he did.
Investigators also looked at credit card history to help determine where Matthew was the night his father disappeared. Records show Matthew used his father's credit card to buy beer at a local Walmart before using it again to ride to Backstreet's Bar in the Cape, and then made multiple calls and cancellations for an Uber ride. With the last call made around midnight, that's when the card was blocked for suspicious activity.
5:33, heads up, I think you'll want the Storm Shield app on your phone today as we are tracking some scattered showers and thunderstorms in the mix, particularly the late afternoon hours. Great app, by the way. I always recommend to download because you can track with us the rains street by street. You could certainly get alerts on there and get all of the latest information right here from the Fox 4 Weather Center. So Storm Shield app, great app, of course, on Facebook and Twitter. We'll keep you up to date on how conditions play out as well. Right now we're dry on Doppler radar, maybe a little bit of a different scenario heading into the afternoon. Mix of sun and clouds will carry us into the 3 o'clock hour. Then we'll start to get a sea breeze developing, and that will focus the better chances just away from the coast. But locations like Fort Myers, Lehigh Acres, Port Charlotte, Punta Gorda, you folks, Immokalee as well, could be getting a decent chance for some rain. And then also pushing back out towards the Gulf Coast late in the day. This model just a little bit strong on the activity, but you get the idea. Some scattered showers, certainly part of the equation, and certainly something I think you should plan for today. Take a look at the temperatures across the country, because this is interesting. You got warm air meeting the cold air back out towards Rapid City and Denver. This helped to generate some showers and thunderstorms throughout portions of Nebraska and the Dakotas. The rain will move towards Iowa and Illinois for today and cause some problems, even severe weather out there. In the meantime, we are going to stay souped up into the heat that will be around. You could see all the way through much of the week, so no real cooler air for us in the forecast here as we make our way towards at least the next 7 days. Right now, we're at 70 degrees in Fort Myers, 73 in Tampa Bay, and 66 in Tallahassee. Your hour-by-hour forecast paints lots of sunshine for today, so very similar setup to yesterday. The difference is I think we'll see more rain than what we saw yesterday, particularly in the late afternoon and early evening hours. I've got your full 7 day forecast in 10 minutes. Right now, Stephanie is tracking your traffic.
Now, on time traffic brought to you by Associates and Bruce L. Shiner, attorneys for the injured.
It is Monday. We are back to another work week, and your morning commute is starting off nice and clear right now as you head down Pine Island Road, Royalty Boulevard to Richard Road. You're looking at about 12 minutes, although we do have some construction on Pine Island that is causing a roadblock. That's going to be the left lane going westbound on Northeast Pine Island at Hibiscus Drive. So expect some delays there in traffic. But right now we're showing green on the map, so nothing to worry about traffic-wise. Just be careful of road crews as you make your way out this morning. Santa Barbara Boulevard as well as Del Prado looking good this morning as you make your commute down Cape Coral Parkway over to Hancock Bridge Parkway. Down Del Prado, that is about 9 minutes. Lafayette Street to Northeast 6th Street down Santa Barbara is about 11 minutes in both your midpoint and your Cape Coral Bridge looking good. We'll send it back to the desk.
Thanks, Steph. We're working to get more information about a deadly crash in Lehigh Acres. It happened yesterday near the intersection of Gunnery Road and Sunset Road. You see here, Florida Highway Patrol tells us one of the drivers didn't stop at a stop sign and hit another car. 53-year-old Marlene Mendoza was the passenger of the vehicle that failed to stop. She died at the hospital. Cape Coral police are also investigating a deadly crash, this one happening yesterday morning at the intersection of Del Prado Boulevard and Northeast 6th Street. The crash happened after a car ran a red light and hit another vehicle that was making a left turn at the intersection. The drivers of both cars were taken to the hospital, and the driver of the car that was hit, 93-year-old Harry Wilson, died at the hospital. Federal officials saying they will soon begin the next phase of a multi-million dollar project to erect a bridge across the Everglades in South Florida. Interior Secretary Sally Jewell announcing the plans to raise a 2.5-mile section of U.S. 41 during a visit to Everglades National Park. She says the Tamiami Trail Bridge project is among the National Park Service's biggest conservation efforts. It will return water flows to more historic levels and sustain the Everglades' sensitive ecosystem. Bridge construction first began in 2009 with the building of the 1-mile bridge. It was finished in 2013, and the latest portion cost $144 million. That's set to be done by 2020. A heads up if you live in Lee County. You may notice some changes to your tap water starting next month. Starting Sunday, Lee County Utilities will be converting its water disinfectant process, and that's expected to last through the 29th. It's considered a routine measure, and it's meant to ensure your water remains safe for use. Officials say your water may taste or smell a little different, but it's still safe to drink. And heads up, Lee County parents, if you applied for school choice online, you're now able to see your enrollment results. Assignment letters for families that did not apply online will be postmarked today. The district urges you not to call the district asking about your child's assignment. The letters are coming in the mail, and the district is unable to provide this information over the phone. The number of children showing up to school with their required shots is dropping, according to the Florida Department of Health. New data sent to the state's 67 districts showing that nearly 93% of kindergarten students, rather, and 90% of seventh graders had their required immunizations this year. The department stated that the lowest vaccination level in a decade, Florida law requires school children to get immunization shots in order to attend school, although the law allows some exemptions. And if you're looking for something to do this week, you'll may be able to tour replicas of Christopher Columbus's ships in Fort Myers. They departed from Naples last week and will remain docked in Pinchers Marina on West 1st Street until tomorrow. So if you're interested in climbing aboard, admissions is $8 for adults, $7 for seniors, and $8 for students ages 5 to 16. Children under 4 get in for free. The ships are open from 9 to 6. And the official logo for the 2020 Tokyo Summer Olympics has been revealed today. After filtering through thousands of entries, a selection committee has unveiled the winning design for the 2020 Olympic Games, entitled Harmonized Checkered Emblem. Its indigo blue rectangular shape represents different countries, cultures, and ways of thinking. Now, do you wash your clothes with laundry pods? Experts warn that you should switch detergents if you have young kids in the house. Companies have made changes to the pods to keep your kids safe, but experts explain why that may not be enough. Plus, don't you hate when you make a purchase and then see the same item for a cheaper price somewhere else? Well, a brand new app is set to be released tomorrow, and that will take the guesswork out of comparing prices. You're watching Fox 4 Rising.
QX60 from Infiniti. Lease the new Infiniti QX60 for $429 a month. Visit your local Infiniti retailer.
Surf, stream, download, and play on multiple devices at once with CenturyLink Internet. Get up to 20 megs for $20 a month for 1 year with autopay when bundled with qualifying home phone plan. Call 855-744-FAST right now. Want to see this as an action movie? Get ready. 20 megs is only $20 a month. Or drama. Get up to 20 megs for $20 a month. Only from CenturyLink. Speed may not be available in your area. Call now.
I'm on my way.
When there's no room for error, rely on the 2016 Nissan Altima with intelligent safety shield technologies like forward emergency braking and blind spot warning. Lease Altima, an IIHS Top Safety Pick Plus, just $189 per month, or save up to $2,250. Take on the mission. Shop ChooseNissan.com.
At Tires Plus, we know taking care of your car isn't the first thing on your mind, until it needs to be. That's why we offer tires, brakes, batteries, and oil, installed quickly by our specialists, so you can get back to what you truly care about. Tires Plus. Get there from here.
They're loving their vegetables.
This is huge news.
It's all thanks to our Bird's Eye Chef's favorite side dishes. Perfectly sauced or seasoned. What are you...
I'm live tweeting.
Oh, boy. Bird's Eye. So veggie good.
How fast can you save at AutoNation?
Beep, beep.
Yeah, that fast.
Save now on new 2016 Corollas with automatic. Just $159 a month. At AutoNation Toyota Fort Myers.
Beep, beep.
A Florida surfer is recovering after a shark attack over the weekend. The 15-year-old was hanging out of New Smyrna Beach Saturday evening. He did a trick on his surfboard and his foot came down on the shark.
Bit me, and I couldn't tell whether it like stepped on a shell or something. But then after it bit me the first time, it bit me another time. And the second time it bit me, it really hurt, and I thought, like, it bit my whole foot off.
He says the shark bit down on his Achilles heel. He tried to walk back to shore, but he couldn't, so a stranger pulled him out. The teen had to get stitches and won't be able to surf for at least a few months. A retired canine is alive after surviving a gator attack. St. Petersburg police officer Chris Leister says a dog named Eric was down by the pond in his yard when Leister heard some splashing and then a yelp. When he looked, he saw a huge chunk missing from Eric's leg and an 8-foot gator out of the water with its mouth open. He says that gator didn't know who he was messing with because this dog is a tough narcotics canine and is trained to fight back. The vet says Eric will make a full recovery.
Time now is 5:44 as you wake up with us on this Monday morning. Certainly hope you had a great weekend. You're taking a live look right now, live over the Coosawhatchee River into downtown Fort Myers, where all is quiet. We've got a nice start to the day. I think we'll see nice sunshine here as the sun rises at 6:54 here this morning. And then the afternoon, though, could get a little bit dicey. We are tracking some rain in the mix here for today. So I think a good idea to grab the umbrella as you're heading out the door. Just take a quick second to find it. I think any day this week, if you're thinking about grabbing it any day this week, today's going to be the day to do it. As we take a look at rainfall tallies, you can see not expecting rain in every backyard or a ton of rain, but in spots we could get about 2/10 to about 1/4 inch of rain, and maybe some spots inland about 1/2. I do think the miles are a little bit exaggerated in LaBelle, giving you folks about 2 inches, but a few showers in the mix for today. As we look at the time, you can see not an all-day event. In fact, much of your morning, early afternoon, it'll be lots of sunshine, really nice conditions. And then as we get into 2, 3 o'clock, we'll start to note just a couple of isolated showers building into the forecast. These will increase in number as we make our way towards the late afternoon, the time you may be heading home from work. You could be dodging a shower or thunderstorm, I think, in your evening commute tonight. That's why, once again, a great idea to download that Storm Shield app. Some of them could be on the heavier side. And then once we make our way towards the evening, these will return to the coast. So once again, coastal spots of Port Charlotte, Fort Myers, down in Naples, I think they'll get a decent shot of seeing some rain here this evening. Right now, check out your temperatures. You're waking up to temperatures running a couple of degrees above average for this time of the year. We've got 69, but 71 in Cape Coral. Forecast for today calls for a high of 86 and mostly sunny. So much of the day will be sunny and dry, but in the afternoon we will see, note some scattered rain. Boating forecast for today could be dodging rain late in the day. The morning, early afternoon looking good. Southwesterly winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas running 1 to 2 feet and a light chop on the bay. Your low tide is at 8:34. Your high tide just around 2:50 here for the afternoon. Your 7-day forecast, only a couple rain showers for tomorrow. Wednesday through the rest of the week, careful out of straight shower each and every afternoon, but I think much of the days will be dry with temperatures getting toasty. That is a look at your forecast. It's 5:47. Stephanie's checking the roads.
Now, on-time traffic brought to you by Associates and Bruce L. Shiner, attorneys for the injured.
Hey, good morning, Southwest Florida. If you are traveling down 75 this morning, your commute looking good. Bonita Beach Road west to Alico Road, that's running about 12 minutes right now, as well as 41 in the Naples and San Carlos Park, as well as Estero looking good this morning. Your commute down 75, also Livingston Road, Windsong Circle, and Sander Bay Drive, all slowing down just a little bit from the last 30 minutes or so, but Airport Pulling Road still running about 40 miles per hour. We've also got some construction in Naples to tell you about. This is Collier Boulevard. You're going to see this north and southbound between Golden Gate Parkway and Green Boulevard. So expect some delays throughout the morning due to that road work. That's a look at your traffic. We'll send it to the desk.
Thanks, Steph. About 30 children each day are still being exposed to the potential dangers of laundry detergent packets. This serious threat continues despite warning and packaging changes. Now experts say more needs to be done. Clark Powell explains.
Soon after being introduced in the U.S. market, thousands of serious incidents involving children and laundry detergent packets forced manufacturers to make changes. They replaced clear containers with opaque ones and made them harder for children to open. But a new study shows during 2013 and 14, there were more than 22,000 incidents in children younger than 6, an increase of 17%.
These children have come in coma, They've stopped breathing. We've even had two deaths in the last 2 years due to exposure to laundry detergent packets.
Dr. Gary Smith of Nationwide Children's Hospital led the study. He looked at several types of detergents, both packets and traditional forms. When children bite down on packets, they burst, shooting a toxic mix into a child's throat. They were associated with more serious medical outcomes, more hospitalizations, and more breathing failure than other types of detergents, as well as two child deaths.
Those concentrated chemicals can cause serious burns. If it gets down the lung, it can cause severe damage. It also, when it's absorbed, can cause effects on the brain.
Experts say parents of young children should avoid using laundry detergent packets altogether, but if they do use them, store them high, out of sight, and out of reach in a locked cabinet.
Some of the manufacturers have actually moved to make the detergent containers less accessible to children. But what we found was, in fact, the number of exposures have continued to increase.
A new app called Prizerazzi is allowing customers to get their money back on items they have already purchased if those items are found to be cheaper elsewhere. The app works by having customers take a picture of the receipt, submitting it, and then Prizerazzi will compare those items against other retailers for 30 days. If they find a match, the customer will receive the difference.
All the big box retailers have a price protection policy or lowest price guarantee. So Best Buy, Walmart, Home Depot, Costco, Toys R Us, any of the big box stores, we check and we work for the consumer to get money back from them.
Now, Prizerazzi is a free mobile app. It's available on Apple, Google, and Android. It starts being available tomorrow. Kelly Ripa will be back on the air tomorrow following a self-styled protest against ABC. The Live with Kelly and Michael co-host sent a late-night email Friday to her staff that said, "We are a family, and I look forward to seeing you all on Tuesday morning." Ripa hasn't been on the show since last Tuesday. That's the day ABC announced that Ripa's co-host, Michael, will be leaving the show to co-host Good Morning America full-time. He was already co-hosting GMA part-time. The move had been in the works for weeks, and GMA co-hosts Robin Roberts and George Stephanopoulos knew in advance. But ABC management decided to withhold the information from Ripa. One astronaut just found out on his world way to be a part of a London marathon. We'll explain how they participated hundreds of miles above the race. You're watching Fox 4 Rising.
Weather is sponsored by Right Choice Realty.
She is a force of nature and natural truth seeker. She tells it like it is, even when we don't want to hear it. She rules when life gets unruly. And for 20 years of honest advice, she has no equal, no limits, and remains unstoppable. Judge Judy.
Weeknights from 5 to 6 on Fox 4.
For less than the average price of a car, you could be driving an extraordinary Mercedes-Benz. One that shatters the standards of performance and shatters the limits of technology. The 2016 GLA, starting at just $32,500, shattering expectations wherever it goes. Lease the GLA 250 for $329 a month at your local Mercedes-Benz dealer.
Big things are happening at AutoNation, so I'm hitting the road to spread the word.
Beep, beep. And I have a wingman.
Just like AutoNation, he's smart and fast. Sure you can keep up? I'll take that as a yes.
Hurry in to AutoNation. Drive new Toyota Camrys for just $199 a month. New Corollas, $159 a month. Drive pink, drive safe, drive now at AutoNation Toyota Fort Myers.
Meep, meep.
Hi, Dad.
For sure. So, if you look at the assets, that was... Are you looking at the right one as me? Yeah.
Sorry about that.
There must be higher love down in the heart.
What do you think?
And in the stars above.
Hi, Ted. Glad you could join us. We thank you.
Swagglers.
They said I was approved online.
Uh-oh,
I smell a butt coming.
Yeah, a big butt.
But I wasn't really approved.
Only drivetime.com gives you a real online approval in 2 minutes. No butts.
Because butts stink.
Butts do stink.
Kind of a double meaning.
What do you mean, huh?
Save yourself. Get a real online approval first. Go to drivetime.com.
A British astronaut just ran the London Marathon hundreds of miles above the actual race.
Yeah, this is pretty incredible. Tim Peake ran on a treadmill yesterday inside the International Space Station just as the real marathon was going on below him. In the British capital, Peake pre-recorded a race countdown that was played on big screens at the starting line. During his race, he watched a virtual reality video that simulated real runners who used the app called Run Social. Peake wrapped up his space marathon in about 3 hours and 35 minutes. Wow. I'm tired for him.
Definitely. Now, from running in space to running in heels.
This is new meaning to beauty is pain. Okay, female impersonators showcasing their high-heeled talents in Key West this weekend. It was part of the Great Conch Republic Drag Race. Contestants put on makeup, wigs, costumes, and very high shoes for the competition. They had to navigate an obstacle course with car tires, a balance beam, shopping carts also full of people. The heels had to be at least 3 inches to qualify.
That is 3 inches too high off the ground for me. Good morning, folks. As we wake up, Doppler radar is dry, but I think you'll need the umbrella here as you head out the door because we're tracking some rain building in the forecast. I'll show you that part of the forecast here coming up, but visibility's still okay. Could be changing as we make our way towards the 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock hour as well. So if you're not leaving now, I definitely want to be sure to check back in as I'll be updating as conditions change here throughout the morning. Wake up weather as the kids may be heading out towards the bus stop. Temperatures not cool at all, upper 60s, some spots still in the 70s. Then we'll see the sun rise. That will make things pretty toasty for today. Here's your forecast. If you live in Arcadia, Lehigh Acres, LaBelle, Clewiston, Golden Gate, you folks will see, I think, the warmer temperatures, in the mid to upper 80s this afternoon. Mostly sunny skies. Some of the rain we'll see today could be heavy at times, mainly after 5 o'clock for you folks. Some of the rain developing a little bit earlier along the coast, harbor zones, Englewood, Port Charlotte, Punta Gorda. It's all about the morning sun. And then the afternoon, you could be dodging some showers as well. The coastal spots looking good. Cape Coral, Bonita Springs as well. Mixture of sun and clouds. And then some scattered afternoon rain possible. At the beaches, it is going to be a mostly sunny day and a mainly dry day. Certainly not a washout scenario. In fact, I think the beach will be booming, especially if you're thinking about heading out there in the early afternoon hours, maybe for lunchtime, about 80 degrees. Easterly winds 5 to 10. Definitely the UV index is booming up to a 10, so you want to protect your skin here if you're planning to make it to the beach. 7-day forecast, afternoon rain, the story for today. Just a slight chance for showers. And each and every afternoon, I really can't rule out about a 10% chance for rain, as we do have the heat, humidity that could easily bubble up some rain along the sea breeze. But look how warm we get. We are flirting with summer, folks. It is on the horizon, but really a nice warm stretch as we close out the last week of April here across Southwest Florida. It is 5:57, and Stephanie's keeping you up to date on the roads.
Now, on-time traffic brought to you by Associates and Bruce L. Shiner, attorneys for the injured.
Warm temperatures, nothing to worry about weather-wise, and also a clear commute is starting out your Monday morning. Does it get any better than that? Royalty Boulevard to Richard Road is running about 13 minutes as you head down Pine Island this morning. Santa Barbara and Del Prado still looking good. Just a few minutes as you travel between Pine Island and your Veterans Parkway area. And then we've also got that construction I wanted to remind you about on Pine Island right here. This is going to be Northeast Pine Island Road, Hibiscus Drive right there. So where you're going to see a roadblock in the left lane, and that's going to be going westbound, so just be cautious of road crews. Hibiscus Drive over to 41, where that construction is, just about 2 minutes right now. And then both of your Cape Coral and your Midpoint Bridge, a couple of minutes across the water. That's a look at your traffic.
This morning, the presidential candidates are gearing up for tomorrow's primary, but not without starting trouble first. How Ted Cruz and John Kasich are teaming up against Donald Trump. Plus, we're following breaking news this morning. A man is in custody after barricading himself in a home with a child inside. We'll have more on this coming up. These stories and more in the 6 o'clock hour of Fox 4 Rising.